So in previous classes, you have learnt about the numbers, especially up to two-digit numbers. Up to two-digit numbers. Okay. So what are digits? First of all, we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. These are called digits. What are these? These are called as digits. These are called digits. So whatever the combination of these digits we are getting. For suppose, when you are counting, think that in my pocket there are no chocolates. So I can say that zero chocolates are there. Suppose someone has given me one chocolate. I can say it has come. One. So if I go on counting the chocolates. Two chocolates, three chocolates, four chocolates, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Nine after? Yes, of course, 10. How these 10 chocolates came to me? After 9, we have found 10. But how this combination of 10 forming? Using the digits. This is one digit and this is also one other digit. So, it is made up of two digits. So, it is having some place value. As already you have learned two digit number in your class 2. About the two digit numbers. Let us firstly recall that one. Tell me what are the place values we are having for two digit numbers? Yes. Firstly, yes, we have ones a digit and the tens a digit. We have ones a digit as well as tens a digit. Now, if I write a number called as 16. Now, which is in the ones place now? 6. Which is in the tens place? 1. So, why this we call it as 16? Because as 1 occupies the tens digit, it is having the place value as 10. And 6 is having the place value as 1. What we call it as? Place value. What is this one? Place value. So we have a number called as 16. How this 16 is constituted means, how this 16 is formed means, this 1 is getting multiplied by 10. 1 is getting multiplied by 10. As well as 1 is, that means this 6 is getting multiplied with the place value 1. This 1 is getting multiplied by the place value 10, 10's place value, and this 6 digit is getting multiplied by the place value 1. So we have 1 into 10 and 6 into 1. When they are going to be added, these two are going to be added. How? 1 into 10, how much? 10. Yes. And 6 into 1, yes, correct. How much it is? 6. When both are added, it is called as 16. We call this multiplication with the place value. Whatever the digits are there, if we multiply the digits with the place value, we call it as expanded form. What is this one? Expanded form. So regarding two digits, you came across this type of things. Now let us fastly go upon next topic. That's nothing but ascending and descending order. What is ascending and descending order? What is ascending order? What is ascending order? Tell me. Yes. Firstly, yes. Arranging the numbers from smallest to the biggest. Arranging the numbers from smallest to the biggest. That is called as ascending order. What we call it as? Ascending order. Ascending, descending. We are having also having descending. Let us concentrate upon ascending. What is ascending? See here. We have some numbers. 24, 12, 8, 32, 18. So this is a number having some two digit numbers as well as single digit numbers. Now I want to arrange these numbers in ascending order. What I have to do? I have to start from the very smallest number. Among the given numbers, I have to write down the very smallest number. Means which is the smallest number? Which is the smallest number? Yes. 8 is the smallest number. So I have to write this 8 here. Understood? After this 8, since 8 is smaller, we have to keep the symbol as less than. What we call it as? Less than. In your starting classes, in the first class, second class, you got this symbol, less than symbol. If the number is smaller, on the left side the number, if it is small, we write as less than symbol. What is this one? Less than. Similarly, if the left side number is a bigger one, we write it as greater than. What we call it as? Greater than symbol. If the numbers are equal, we call it as equal. So this thing we have learned. Now the same symbol I have to apply here. When ascending order is written, whenever we are writing the ascending order, take the numbers, whatever the numbers you have taken, and among those numbers, take from the very smallest one. Start from the very smallest one. Which is the smallest one? 8. After 8, which is the smallest one? In the counting, yes, 12 will come. So this 12 should be written. After 12, again smallest, smaller symbol, that is less than symbol. 8 less than 12, and again 12 is less than what? Yes, 18. After 18 which one? Yes, 24. Before writing 24 again, smaller symbol. That means less than symbol. Now, one more number is remaining. Which is that number? Yes, of course, 32. We can easily tell. 32. But before 32, less than symbol. So, whenever you see this type of arrangement of numbers with this smaller, that means less than symbol, it is called as ascending order. One more example we will take. Okay, one more problem. So we have some numbers, bigger numbers I will take. 98, 87, 42, 30, 16, 72. So how to arrange these numbers? The counting, which is the smallest number we are getting at in this one? Yes, 16. After 16, which is the smallest number? Yes, 30. But before 30, what did I say? We have to keep the less than symbol. After this one 30, Which is the smallest number among the remaining? 42. Isn't it? Next, after this 42, which is the smallest number? Yes, 72. After 72, which is the smallest number? Yes, 87. No, of course, one small number, that is last number is a remaining, that is 98. Of course, it will come in the last. This is called as ascending order. Clear? Understood? Yes. So, in a similar way, we have to write down the descending order. So, what is descending order? In ascending order, what we did there? We have moved from the smaller number. We have arranged the numbers. Arranged. That means arranging of numbers from smallest to the largest. We have arranged the numbers smallest to the largest. In descending order, what we will do? Reverse. How? What is the reverse? First, we will write the largest number. So, we will arrange from largest to smallest. Now, we will go for the next topic, descending order. So, next, descending order. So, what is descending order? Same question. Arranging numbers from smallest or biggest? Smallest or biggest? Yes. That is biggest. That is largest. From largest to the smallest. So, this is the meaning of descending order. Descending order. So, we will take one example. What is that example? We will take one some new numbers. Okay. 22, 16, 2, 28, 14, 17. Now, we have to arrange these numbers in a descending order. Descending order means from largest to the smallest. What is the smallest number here? Which is the largest number? Not sorry. Smallest. Largest. Which is the largest number? Yes. 28. 28 is the largest one. Largest means what? What was the symbol we have used? Which is symbol for should be used here? Less than symbol or greater than symbol? Yes. Greater than symbol we have to use. After this greater than symbol, which is the next largest number? 22. After 28, 22. 22 after 16 or 17? 17. 17 after 16. 14. 2. But what should come between the numbers? Yes, greater than symbol. It should be followed it. Otherwise, you will get confused. 28 greater than 22. It shows the order that it is in descending order. Clear? So, this is regarding the ascending order, descending order. So, a few more examples I will give in the worksheet. Okay, you can solve them in the worksheet. Next, after this descending order, we will move on to the topic called as successor and predecessor. successor and predecessor. What is successor? In primary level classes, for your convenience, you might have learned the numbers like this. For example, 14 dash dash dash. Next, dash dash dash, some 20. What is the meaning of that one? 14 after? 14 after? 15, 16, 17, 18. So what we call them as? In your primary level language, you will learn after numbers. Remember? After numbers. Similarly here, 20 before, 19, 18, 17. We call them as before numbers. The same after number before, nothing but here. These after numbers are called as successor. And before numbers are called as predecessor. So we'll see one example. So whenever a question is asked, what is the successor of 9? What is the successor of 9? Successor means nothing but here, remember, after number. What is that the successor? When you add plus 1, you will get the next number, after number, isn't it? This is called as successor. Similarly, predecessor means before number. Before number. When you are going for the after number, you are moving front. That's why you are adding. Here, before number, that is predecessor. You want to go back. For example, 9 itself. What is the predecessor of 9? Now, this time, when you are going for before number, you have to subtract. Understood? Successor of 9 is 10. How that 9 came? 9 plus 1. Predecessor of 9? 9 minus 1. Now here 10 is called as the successor of 9 and here 8 is called as the predecessor of 9. Similarly, few more examples. 14 plus 1, 15. Similarly, tell me predecessor for 14. 14 minus 1, 13. Similarly, 16. 16 plus 1, how much? 17. For predecessor, what we have to do? Minus 1, that is 15. One point you have to keep in mind that success are nothing but after number. To get that after number, you have to plus 1. When you want to get the predecessor, this before number, you have to do minus 1. Understood? So let us firstly revise today's topic. So what we have learned in today's class? So first of all, we discussed about the digits. What are the digits we have? What are the digits we have? Yes, 0 to 9. 0 to 9. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are called as the digits. And we have discussed about the place value. Place values, especially regarding two-digit numbers. Two-digit numbers. What are the place values it will contain? Ones and tens. After that, we have discussed about the ascending order. What is ascending order? Arranging the numbers from smallest to the largest. सिमिलरली डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर, डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर मीन्स लार्जेस्ट रिवर्स ऑपोजिट टू द असेंडिंग ऑर्डर, लार्जेस्ट टू द स्मॉलेस्ट. Now after this one we have discussed, what we have discussed? Successor. Successor, how to get the successor of a number? You just add 1, plus 1. If you do plus 1, you will get the successor. Predecessor. What is the predecessor? Yes. Opposite to this one, minus 1. So these 6 topics we have discussed in today's class.